I tell you what, we're already having a wonderful day.
Absolutely.
Well, welcome everyone to the September edition of the Chamber Chat
program. Is it September already?
I know. I had to practice that. It feels like it. Yeah. Ought to be way back then. Yeah.
Blink.
But anyway, we got lots of good news. Got lots of great guests.
Yes.
But first, we got to talk about our new chamber member. You know I love that.
Yeah.
This is Cumberland Container. Now, they're actually located at 1027 North Chestnut Street in Monterey, but they do a lot of business here in DeKalb County.
Wow, that's great.
This 47-year-old company produces, listen to this, Jen, this is impressive, 200 million feet of boxes annually.
Wow, that's a lot of boxes.
That's a lot of boxes. Wow. Yeah. So if your business needs boxes or packing materials, just call Mark Jared, super duper nice guy, 931-839-2227. Or if you didn't get that, call the chamber and I'll get you the number.
Or CumberlandContainer.com.
Yeah.
Yay!
I know, I'm
well,
so excited.
Well, welcome, and thank you so much for joining the chamber.
Well, we gave out two community improvement awards.
Yes.
I love this, because both of them involved food. yeah, I love it when there's food. But anyway, Hardee's, of course, located at 135 West Broad Street, Smithfield. All the beautiful upgrades on the exterior.
Really looking good.
And the interior. Everything the customer can see.
Yeah.
Has been changed and beautified even more. But they've got, you know, there was new paint, of course, new signs. There was new landscaping, new sidewalks, new paving. Oh, my goodness. They put a lot of effort there. And then on the inside, everything the customer can see has been enhanced.
It is gorgeous in there.
It looks beautiful.
Early.
And I know, Shan, you're an artist. So you're going to love.
On some days.
But they've got this wall of art, beautiful custom designed art that's got a lot of our iconic community symbols on it.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for the day when you want us to do that at the chamber.
Oh,
I'm sorry. No, that was a horrible idea. It was a horrible
idea. That sounded
idea.
Like an offer.
I love that. Oh.
Yes, I love that. Shan, you just get right on that.
I'll add that to my bucket list.
And this is a new thing. This is another thing that I didn't add to the newspaper. The new sidewalks, the handicapped parking area, and the bathrooms are all ADA compliant. So he wanted me to let everybody know that. That's important.
That is really good.
Yeah, that's really good.
It looks great and has some real practicality to it.
Yes. And manager Mark Harrell, whom I love. I have breakfast with him about every Saturday. My husband and I do. He wants to thank their numerous customers for the many years of continued support. And I think Hardee's has been here since 1987.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
Another thing I'm older than. It's just, anyway. And the other one, Mike's Flower Shop in Alexandria, located on the public square
there.
I love
Mike.
I
love him.
Yep. My goodness, you love him because you love what's in his store.
He is so talented.
He's really talented.
But anyway, he's got new paint and landscaping on the outside, plus a beautiful new sign. Mm-hmm. I love it. It's got a bird on the sign, Jen. You know I love birds.
I do.
And here was the best part, Jen. And Kathy, you would have loved this. You're going to be sorry you missed this. He, on the inside, he had rocking chairs sort of circled around. And his mama had all these, Mama Betty, had all these homemade goodies. I mean, a table full.
Oh, that's where the food came in.
Oh, my goodness. I sat there and we talked and ate for like an hour. Y'all are going to have to dock my pay. Because let me tell you, it was a lot of fun.
No, you were on the job.
Then you had to rock
that's
off
important.
All the calories.
We can, yeah. I'm still working on that one. But anyway, we had so much fun. And I just enjoyed hanging out with them. And the mayor was there. And Stacy Baker. And I'm going to... Shan's going to be writing a press release soon. But we have a satellite office for the chamber in Alexandria now. So they are fully stocked.
Yes.
If I've got it at the Smithfield Chamber, we have it at the Alexandria Chamber.
Mm-hmm.
All right,
and
I'm
love saying, that. That's convenient, you know, because it's a big deal to take that extra 15 minutes to drive to get something when it can be right there. So this was a great idea.
Well, and actually Alexandria also has a lot of different kind of traffic. Tourism and interest than what we have in
this office,
in the main chamber office. And so people come into the fairgrounds or come into the old cemetery. There are lots of really wonderful things in Alexandria. So may as well capture all those folks coming into our town, you know, our community,
and
give
serious.
Them more information.
They went and bought new display racks. They're having a new sign made. It's fabulous. So anyway, I'm so appreciative to Tony and Stacy, and I went and visited with them too.
Good.
But I took a lot of that food with me when I was going up there. But anyway, Shan, I know you've got a busy day, so I put you at the first of the program, but I know you've got St. Thomas DeKalb Hospital updates.
Oh, I do. I do. Now, I'm sorry, first off, I couldn't be on the show last month to talk about this. And yes, we are officially St. Thomas DeKalb. We're only a month in, so we're still new little babies in the St. Thomas world. But I just want to say, it has been 30 days of wonderful. So many great things are happening with our hospitals across our region. And I'm going to start off with something that I'm hoping it moves you as much as it moved me. But the CEO of St. Thomas came down and let us know about, you know, here's our new mission statement. This is what we believe. And basically, if you're not on board or you're uncomfortable with this, you are in the wrong place, because they are bold. Yeah. And they are unmoving about their convictions. So I want to let you know about our mission here. And this is just in a three-sentence nutshell. They will say it's too hard, that it cannot be done. The obstacles are just too great to overcome. To which we will say, we are different. We are children of God, powerful beyond measure. Playing small and safe does not serve the world, so we will not do so. We were meant to shine, born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. And as we shine, we give the people around us permission to do the same. Beautiful. If it is right, it can and will be done. They will say it's too hard and it cannot be done, and we will reply, with God and each other, nothing shall be impossible.
I love that. Moving, I feel inspired.
Moving stuff. And speaking of moving stuff, this is the moment I have been waiting for weeks and weeks and weeks. Yeah. We can announce our new CNO has been chosen, and she was already our interim CNO, so we were all rooting for her, and we already love her, Amanda Burgess.
Oh, Amanda's awesome.
She is so wonderful, so kind, so compassionate toward our patients and our staff. Just a great fit as our new CNO. So we want to welcome Amanda, even though she's already one of us. Also, an opportunity for DeKalb County and Cannon County. We have a lunch and learn coming up, and this is free to senior adults or anyone who would like to drop in and learn about colonoscopy screenings. And that's going to be at the Cannon County Senior Center, but it's open to everyone. A free lunch at 11:30 on September 16th. And Dr. Sunil Savaria will be holding that lunch and learn and answering all your questions. So it's always nice when you can get a doctor to answer your questions for free.
And all that you were saying, did I hear free lunch?
Free lunch.
Oh,
yes, you did.
Did
she
have to hear that?
Up that one.
Happy I'm taking lunch that day.
You're so generous. So generous.
To learn all about colonoscopies. Awesome.
I know. Learned really get me.
Let me tell you, when you're my age, those things are important.
They are important. You'll eat anything and listen
George
to free medical
George Oliver
advice.
And I had this conversation yesterday. Yes. All right, go ahead. Moving right along.
It's a probing subject.
George has a way with words.
Yes.
Now, our fall senior health fair at Family Medical Center is coming up. So mark your calendars for October. We're not releasing the dates yet, but October. So just mark off the whole month.
It's just big guess. Just, you
that's
know,
right,
show
that's right.
up
some Saturday in October. I mean, you know, just keep your calendar open. And if you haven't noticed our new signage, we have temporary signage across the hospitals, but the permanent signage is coming, and it is spectacular. I got to see the proofs yesterday. So anyway, new things in store. And if you're not a friend of our St. Thomas DeKalb Facebook page, go ahead and be a friend, because we're going to start sharing some free information, free medical advice, things like that. And you know, free is great.
Oh, really?
I know.
Yeah,
you're
really.
Love
free. Yeah.
Suzanne perks up at free.
I do. But I love their main saying, with God, nothing shall be impossible.
With God and each other.
Oh, with God and each other. Oh, we did it. But anyway.
Feel the love. So
I know, feel
thank
the love.
You so much for having me on this morning.
Oh, I'm not through with you.
Oh, okay. Well, this just means more work for me. I can feel
no,
it.
No, no, no. I just happen to know
something
you.
Something we love to talk about.
Your sister, Beth, are in charge of the Tennessee State Fair pageants.
That's correct.
We have, DeKalb County is full of beautiful girls. Inside and out.
I like DeKalb County girls to compete, because so many times across the almost 200 awards, we have so many from DeKalb County that plays. And so that makes me proud because I love these girls and I've supported them since they were little. So it's a great time to come out and let your county shine and be the most beautiful in the state. But that's going to be September 18th and 19th. September 19th is our traditional state fair pageants for all Tennessee girls ages birth to 20. But then on Friday evening, we do something very special. We have the Miss Sparkle pageant, and that is put on through us and sponsored by Metro Parks Disabilities for any girl with special needs from moderate to severe disabilities. And this is a free pageant that is fully sponsored and paid for, you know, at our cost, so that we can help all these girls feel beautiful and compete. And I said, you know, I'm not going to do it unless every girl gets a crown. I'm just not going to do it. So the state fair said, okay, we can work with that. So every girl is going to get a mini tiara, and then we will have queens that are crowned. And one of the sweetest statements with a contestant last year, I said, are you nervous? Have you ever been in a pageant before? You know, or do you feel beautiful? And she goes, oh, I've done one before. Why would I be nervous? Oh. Her sweet little innocent attitude of, I'm not afraid. You know, so I loved working with these girls. And I cried a million tears because it was just so beautiful. But it is my favorite thing to do.
Well, I heard there was a dry in the house.
It makes me cry thinking about it now. But anyway, if you know a girl ages 4 to adult with any type of disability, please feel free to have them contact us or contact Metro Parks Disabilities or go to our Facebook page, Tennessee State Fair Pageants. And once again, this is a free pageant to these girls, and we'd love to have every one of them.
Well, so to sign up for any girls, just go to
TennesseeStateFair.org or our website, Studio6Limited.com, and it's online registration, easy as pie, and you can pay at the door. It's a very simple process.
Ah, love it. Well, thanks, Jen.
Yay.
Jen.
Yes.
I talked to Catherine Pack. She came to the office last week, and she said that on September the 18th is Purple Out Day.
Really?
You know what that is?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, so is the information here?
Uh-huh. I was just seeing it here.
Well, about the Purple Out.
Well, let's see. Yes, I think it is. Okay, but anyway, it's to bring awareness about Alzheimer's.
Yes.
So wear your what color?
Purple.
Purple that day.
Well, and it's a special thing for me because my dad has Alzheimer's.
That's right.
And so the Alzheimer's Association is a real... has been a godsend for our family, just to gather information and to know what to expect and how to still be caring, loving caregivers for our dad. So Alzheimer's is a great organization, but I don't know about this.
Well, now you know. Well, you just wear your purple that day.
Oh, just for awareness.
It's for awareness. And Catherine said people have been making donations. It sort of turned out they didn't mean to start that. But so if you want to make a donation that they'll, you know, present to the organization, stop by and see Catherine.
Okay.
It's pretty awesome, huh?
Yeah.
So don't forget your purple that day. And, you know I hear you brag a lot about Web House, the good job they do taking care of their people out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, your dad's awesome, too. I love your dad. But anyway, now look who's here, Jen. From Justin Potter Library, Coco's here.
Hi.
Kathy Hendrickson to tell us all about what's going on with the library.
At the libraries, yes. Well, starting off, September is Library Card Sign-Up Month, so we're encouraging everyone that doesn't have a library card, you know, there's people that's lived in this county all their life, didn't know we had a library, come by and get a free library card.
There's somebody who doesn't know we have this fabulous, fabulous library.
You'd be surprised. Yeah. And this gives you access to books and movies and free downloadable audiobooks through Reads, music CDs, magazines, and we have internet, wireless access. I'm a notary. We have make copies and we scan and we print and we have voters registration forms, voting tests, and much more.
Wow.
Programs. So we're staying busy. So I encourage you to come out and get you a library card. And today at 10 o'clock, our Zentango art class, and it will be in the DeKalb Community Center art room. So go over there and be creative today. Get your creation on. Book sale is still going on through September the 11th, and we still have lots and lots of books.
So you know what I did? So, you know, usually when I come in to buy books for the book sale, I leave with a box full of, of books. So this time, I had a plan. I got there at 10 minutes before closing.
Yeah.
That way, I only had enough time to get 3 books. What do you think of that? Was that good?
That's
pretty good.
Yeah. You didn't buy 4. You just bought 3.
I only bought 3. Yeah, I had 10 minutes. and I got three instead of a box load. So, uh-huh. Jen, you may think of that plan.
Oh, yeah. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah.
I usually bring a box and take a box.
We tell them we'll load the trunk up.
I swap them around. Yeah, I love books.
I missed the closing and she has cut it that
way. And we are still having our free computer classes, and we are starting a free 6-week journey through the Microsoft Office series. And that will start on Monday, September the 14th, and it will run through Monday, October the 19th. And those classes will be at 5:30 in the Motlow classroom at the DeKalb County Complex. So come by, and it's with our FactGram, which we'll be working on for another year. So we'll still have some more and more computer classes. And we are partnering with Michael Deaver and Hillary Bluckett from the Health Department for a free 6-week, 2-hour workshop. Titled Take Charge of Your Diabetes. And we have so many people in this county that do have that, finding out every day that
yes.
they do have diabetes. We are starting that workshop, and it will start on Wednesdays, starting on September the 16th, and it will continue through Wednesday, October the 21st. The classes will be from 12:30 until 2:30 at Justin Potter Library. And they're going to cover, it's like 6 sessions, and it's going to cover all types of information, food and taking care of yourself and just all types of information.
Recipes?
Probably.
Yeah.
You know, I say there's each session is going to be something a little different. Okay. And you do have to register for these classes because we space is limited at the library. So we're taking probably around 20. So we have the registration. So we've already got about 9 signed up. So we've got the registration forms at the library, and I think they have some at the health department. So come by and register for that. I think it's going to be very interesting. We've had more people contact us about this, so we're looking forward to this, to working with them. And the new school year starting.
Yeah.
Tennessee Promise is starting back up mm-hmm. for the new students, the new seniors this year. So we met with the Lori Myrick at the high school and the principal, and we met with Amanda from Tennessee Achieves at the high school the other day. We were talking about this. We're having a Tennessee Promise mentor recruitment meeting, and that starts Thursday, September the 17th, and that'll be at 4:00 at the UT Extension Room in the DeKalb County Complex. They need 20 more mentors. I think they're projecting about 188 students this year, of course, give or take. And they have to have those in by November the 20th is the deadline for the mentors. And we, as we did last year, we're going to be working with the students this year again for the community service. And they need not to think that the community service is over. It's an ongoing, they have to do community service, I think, every semester or something like that. So they have another deadline. They've already completed the ones through the summer, but started August 1st through December, they have to do another 8 hours of community service.
Mm-hmm. And, that's not punishment for them. Because
it's just
awesome to be able to get involved in the community and learn to be a volunteer and to do things without
Well, and a lot of volunteer work helps you know in your career whether that's something you're going down the right path.
Yeah.
To find some place where you have an interest might actually end up being your career.
So we're going to be signing them up, and they do need to come by, and they do need to get a volunteer form and have their parents sign it, get it back to us. I think last year they did in the county 650 community service hours were completed.
Wow. Nice.
So that's neat.
And that's a win-win.
And they had really a great turnout, these kids, that followed through with it. So we're really appreciative of that. So call us, and we'll get you set up. And we are really, really excited about this. It's one of our first outreach projects over at the complex where we have our room over there for that. We are doing a book share partnership with the Smithville Elementary School. I talked about it a little bit last month about getting the teachers signed up with library cards, and hats off to the teachers. They have just come through. I think every teacher and assistant and everybody in the school get a library card. So hats off to them. We really appreciate Principal Vincent and working with us on this and partnering with us. And especially Jane Ramsey. She's kind of worked with Rochelle, and they've kind of put this thing together. So we're really excited about this. And the kickoff date will be September 15th. The more resources and services we provide our teachers, the better opportunity our children have for learning, achieving, and growing. Oh. So that's our goal. So we're really excited about this. And so,
does take a village.
It does take a village.
Yep.
I think there's anything that we can't do if we all work together. So that's... Anyway, that's our big thing going on.
As usual, you're so busy. Thank you. Hey, Jen, you're going to like this.
Yeah.
I don't think we've ever announced this before. A 4-H chicken show and auction. Yeah, it's September 22nd at the DeKalb County Bus Garage. Now, listen to this. The show starts at 6 p.m. with the auction immediately following. So that means they're having a beauty pageant for chickens? I don't know. What do you, Sharon's
it's,
over here
it's
now. Sharon
kind, Evans. Kind of what an auction is.
A beauty pageant for chickens. But anyway, everyone's welcome to come bid on some of the best locally raised Rhode Island red hens you've ever seen.
Well, there you go. I'm excited. Oh. I think that's a great event.
I know. Doesn't that sound fun?
Yes, it does.
Call 615-597-4945 for more information on this chicken beauty pageant.
That's right.
I'm sure they'll love me for saying that. Yeah, I'm going to be getting calls later today.
Well, normally we don't eat our pageant contestants.
That's right. And, there'll be no chicken served at this show. Oh my goodness. Well, talk about somebody who's not a chicken, because he's sitting over here next to me right now to talk about the 43rd annual Rotary Fish Fry. Well, Oliver's here.
I'm proud to be here. I gotta tell you, I was just thinking about following a chicken show.
That's right. You're just got a fish.
That's the first time in 10 years that I followed the chicken show.
I did that on purpose, George. I set you
but
up.
But that is a week earlier than our fish fry.
That'll work.
You have a chicken week.
No competition.
And then you have a fish week. You know, it just keeps going.
It's going to be the 26th of September. And we've chose that date because it's a volunteer away game, so we won't be interfere with the Vols, and we'll have radios and whatever that we need to have around for that.
I always check my schedule for that too.
For a family, I've been selling these tickets for 10 years, and everybody asks me, how much are they? Well, they're always the same, $35 for a family, which is hard to beat to take a whole family out to dinner and have a nice fried catfish dinner.
And get to hang out with your community
and
friends.
And some of your best friends.
And get a chance to win one of those fabulous door prizes.
Everybody comes. So you like them, you sit on one side. You don't like them, you sit on the other side.
It's a big park. It's a big park.
Everybody's welcome. Catholics, Baptists, the whole nine yards.
You're going to take Baptists? Wow.
Oh, yeah. We got to have Baptists. Yeah. They're a big mainstay of our ticket sale.
They're eaters. We're Baptists. We like our food.
We appreciate the support for our fish fry every year, because it does go to the things that Rotary stands for and it participates in. We're internationally, it's the Polio Plus campaign, which is throughout the world. There's only three countries left that are not polio free. And we've been participating with the World Health Organization for about 25 years or 30 years with that. But a leader, and also with the Mr. Rich guy from Gates.
Oh, Bill Gates.
Bill Gates and Melinda are big providers of several hundred million dollars a year to this project. And also in the state, We sent two individual, boy and a girl, to boys state and girls state. We have youth activities that we have in October that we send to. We contributed to the health weekend back in June or July or a little earlier. And we're just a lot of things in the community. We have our Rotary Youth of the Month. Then from those nominees, we select our three or four $750 scholarship.
Wow!
For the high school seniors. So, and we're happy to be doing that. We've increased our number of scholarships and the amount so over the years. So it's something we want to continue. But we appreciate the support we've gotten.
Support the Boy Scouts, which we really so appreciate.
Boy
that
Scouts,
too.
You name it. Again, there's a lot of things that we touch that people never know.
Mm-hmm. What about the youth leaders? I mean, in the leadership DeKalb class, the Smithville Rotary Club supports the youth participant.
That's right.
Yeah.
And we do that every year. Of course, that's not free. So we like to invite you and your family out. There'll be hot dogs and stuff for the kids. So if they don't eat fish, or if you don't eat fish and the kids eat fish, whatever, we've got a hot dog. So and tickets can be purchased. I'm selling the tickets, and I'm about out of mine, but you can see Reed Vanderpool at the Smithville Review, and his wife, Julia at Cumberland Insurance. Uh-huh. She has a few left, so contact any road to remember, and we'll be glad to try to get you a ticket.
It's a big time. Fast. The food is great, but also there are fabulous door prizes, and it's always a great evening. And we know that when we support the Rotary Building or the Rotary Club, we're supporting all those other activities as well. So we hope you have a great event. Thanks for coming.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, George. Oh, look here, Jen, the 12th annual Habitat for Humanity's Chili Cook-Off and Bake Sale is coming up.
One of my favorite events.
Right around the corner, and Sharon Evans is here. Hey, Sharon.
Yes, hello.
Good morning. Well, tell us all about it.
Well, there's going to be food.
Oh, you know I love that.
Good news for you. We've scheduled the 12th annual Chili Cook-Off and Bake Sale for October 2nd. So that's a Friday, and we've moved the date a little bit earlier, but we try to find the date that the most people can come. So if the weather's good, we'll be down on the square around the courthouse, and we'll have our teams set up, and you can come have some chili. If it's bad weather like last year, we're thrilled that we can use the county complex building, which worked really well, but hopefully we'll be outside. But we'll make that announcement closer to time. So come 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock, you can come and eat all the chili you want. This year, we're just going to say, just make a donation. So whatever you want to donate, then you can eat however much chili you can fit. So make a donation.
They might lose money on you and me, Jan.
Well, and we do have to say it is a competition. So part of the event is that you can find the chili of choice, but it's really good to go around and sample everyone so that you can vote. And every booth has their own little theme and decoration, and lots of folks put a lot of time and effort into it. It's a great event.
It's a wonderful community event, and our teams are the ones who make this great. So if you are interested in having a team, you are welcome to do so. You're invited to make 5 gallons of your favorite chili and bring it. So we have forms, and that is available at the chamber, or you can contact Tisha Puckett Pryor at her office to get a form if you need that as well.
Bake sale items?
There's also a bake sale. Yeah, that's separate from the chili. You can buy baked goods as well. So if your community organization or your church would like to donate items, we love having those. We have many famous bakers.
We do.
So it's October 2nd. And the new thing we're also going to do, you vote by buying a bowl of chili, and then you get a ballot, but we're also going to have the people's choice, and each booth will have a jar. So if you really like that chili and you want them to earn the Golden Spoon Award, uh-huh, you can stuff their jar, and all that money will also go to Habitat for Humanity.
Yay!
Oh, great idea.
That's one of my favorite events of the year.
Yeah,
I love it. Well, we're going to be praying for really, really good weather. How about
me
that?
Too. Yeah. Thanks
for being here.
Ooh, Jen, look here. Do you know where you are now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I was going to let you say that. There we go.
Yours is different than mine.
Oh, what happened? Oh, you got the old coffee.
I guess I got the old coffee.
I'm understanding now what's going on here. Okay, so the 43rd annual. Wait, no, we're not wearing it down here. We're at the four-person golf scramble.
Oh, I do have that one.
You got that? Uh-huh. Yeah. All right. So I'm seeing you got a different copy than I've got. So here's where we are. Yeah. Go ahead.
A four-person golf scramble is to benefit the golf program at DCHS.
Yeah.
So this is Labor Day. The event is on Labor Day, Monday, September 7th at the Smithville Golf Course. Cost is $75 per person, and that includes lunch, Milliken's, which is really important, and red tea. Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So for more information, I guess just call the chamber and we'll get you connected to the I don't think you have to have teams. I think you just show up and pay $75 per person.
Well, that's a lot of fun.
I know. Yeah, that's a great thing.
If you can play golf. So anyway, Shan was talking about lunch and learn earlier.
Yeah.
Well, we've got another lunch and learn. This is a lunch and learn sponsored by the Smithville Review. It's called How to Make Your Business a Success in Today's Mobile Society.
Mm.
And it's going to be Wednesday, September the 30th at the UT Extension Room at the DeKalb County Complex from 12 to 1. And Angie says to let everybody know, businesses must embrace technology now or become irrelevant.
Yeah.
Oh, so you can enjoy a free Woo-hoo. Light lunch and a short presentation on how to make your business a success in today's mobile society. Boy, I tell you what, that was hard to say. It's limited to only 50 attendees, and there's no cost to attend. Oh. So please RSVP to the Smith for Review by September the 18th, 615-597-5485, or just email Angie at angie@smithvillereview.com.
Now, I just have to say a word for how much I appreciate that Angie and the Smithville Review are, that they're putting this on.
Uh-huh.
Because just as an example, yeah. If you have a cell phone,
uh-huh.
If you are in business for yourself, you do a service, you provide, you're a contractor, you do a roofing, whatever it is. If you have a cell phone as your main line for business, but you don't have a presence on the internet, people cannot find your phone number.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm just saying, if because those, the brand new phone book came out, DTC's beautiful brand new phone book, but cell phone numbers are not in there.
That's right.
And so this is really, just think about it. If you rely on your cell phone for generating business, if you don't have a presence on somewhere, that people can't find you.
And also, since you've talked about that, I'm going to tell you all about it next month, but the Chamber is partnering with the Tennessee Small Business Development Center at Tennessee Tech, and we're going to have a special day on November the 20th, before all the great Christmas shopping starts up, to make sure you're all signed up, you're on, you're online. It's a free thing. You'll be giving away lots of prizes and stuff, little free bag stuff to everybody, but you can come in and make sure you're going to have a strong Google presence.
Yeah.
So we're gonna take care of that for you on November the 20th, but I'll have you all the details next month.
That sounds great.
Isn't that awesome?
Yep.
Oh, talking about awesome, look who's here. Edgar Evans, State Park Manager, Jacob Young is here.
Thank you.
Hey, Jacob.
Good morning.
How y'all doing?
Great.
Did you bring Maisie today?
I did not bring Maisie.
Oh.
I'll bring her next month if you want me.
Okay, bring her next month. I think I'm over my snake phobia.
Well, we'll try it
maybe
again.
Not totally, but I'm gonna do better.
We'll try it again next month.
I'm gonna do it without hyperventilating on the air. Yeah. We'll see.
We can do it.
Okay, Jacob, what's going on?
Well, you may have to help me here. We've got a lot of events coming up this fall, so I'll just work down the list. The 10th annual History Hayride is coming up.
On October 10th.
On October 10th. So we're excited about that. I'm excited. This is the first time I've got to see this event. And it will run from 1:30, probably end up around 9 or 9:30 that night. It's a really neat event. You get on a wagon up at the park office and travel through the park on an hour and a half to 2 hour circuit. And you learn about the history of the area, the county. I know some of you guys have helped out before.
I love this event. It's one of my favorites.
It's a neat event. I'm looking forward to doing that. And last year, I know it was rained out, so everybody's excited this year. You can go to TennesseeVacation.com. I've got the whole link, but it's a little bit difficult. But just go to TennesseeVacation.com, and you can scroll over to history events, or just go through the calendar till you get to October 10th and you can register there.
I think there's a link, if you're on Facebook, I think there's a link, find the Friends of Edgar Evans State Park and on Facebook, and they actually have a link there as well. So hopefully folks can find where to make a reservation.
you're right, you can get to it from that. And something else that's coming up is the Fall Color Cruise on October the 31st.
Oh,
and
this
again,
is another great event.
And again, you can go through
event.
And register for that event through there as well.
Are the colors going to be good this year?
They should be beautiful. With the amount, I won't get into that, but with the amount of rain that we've had, the colors should be gorgeous. That will be kind of toward the end of the cycle, but it still should be a beautiful time to be on the lake. But yeah, there'll be some pretty colors there during that.
Is that on a Saturday?
Yes, ma'am. That's on Halloween.
Oh, that's what I was thinking. Okay.
But it'll be earlier in the day, okay. So you'll have time to get back in before it gets dark or for whatever your plans are for that evening. Also in the park, we're going to have a trunk or treat event coming up this year. This will be the first year that we've done that on October the 24th. We need help from campers. We need you to come in, fill the campground up. this is an event that we've done at Roan Mountain for years, but it will not work if we don't get people into the campground. Mm-hmm. And so we need you to fill it up, come in, decorate your site. We're going to give out prizes for the best decorated sites, and then the campers will give out candy to the trick-or-treaters as they go around. We'll have a bonfire. This is a free event to attend, and your kids will have a very controlled, safe environment to trick-or-treat. So we're excited about doing that as well.
And you get to go camping.
And you get to go camping, yeah. And it should be a beautiful weekend as well, again, for the colors. Some other things that are coming up, the star trails, we mentioned it last time.
Oh, the photography.
Take the pictures of the stars, and it makes a circle in the sky. That is beautiful, and that has been popular.
You've got, on your website, it shows you what it looks like, the picture. It's beautiful.
It's gorgeous. Yeah. And there's another one coming up October the 9th. They have been filling up. So if you're interested in this, the fall color cruise, especially the history hayride, they're filling up, and they're filling up quick. So you can call for the photography workshop and sign up at the park. The fall color cruise and the history hayride, go online and do that at tennesseevacation.com. And then another thing we've got coming up, make sure we get everything here. For National Public Lands Day, we've got the Merritt Trail maintenance. This is our long trail in the park. This is the one that you can make a 7.5 to 9 mile hike out of. And we have been shorthanded with rangers for the last several months. So we've gotten behind on that. We need help getting that trail cleaned up. We've got new signs to put out there. So that is Saturday, September the 26th. And I know we've gotten out of order on our dates.
So can you use the Tennessee Promise?
Yes.
Students for this?
Yes, and we probably will. And we've got students coming this weekend as well. We're getting a lot of students off that, and we love to have you, so please come. But you can do the Tennessee Promise for that. 8 a.m. September 26th, we'll just meet at the park office. Be prepared to be out there most of the day. Bring lunch, bring water, good shoes.
Gloves.
This is a long trail. We'll probably be accessing it by boat at some point in the day to get the signs in. This is a worthwhile project, and we really need a lot of help with that. So I believe that's all the events that we've got coming up.
Well, I had a couple of things I wanted to bring, or just one, actually. You know, I think coming up with the cold snap and the weather will be coming pretty soon. That's the time to go hiking.
It is the time to go hiking.
Because no snakes.
The snakes are going back to their den sites, so you don't have to worry about them too much. And something I've noticed in the park. Now, I love the crazy and I love the crowds and I like people running all over the park, but it's slowed down. School started back and it's slower now. You can get out, see the wildlife. The leaves are starting to fall and it's cooler. It's a beautiful time to hike. So,
and you've got all, you can go for very, very short hikes and that are easy to difficult to, I mean, as much as you want, right?
Yeah, you've got them listed here. We've got the Dunham Cemetery Trail, you know, a tenth of a mile, the Evan Ridge Trail, half a mile, Campground Marina Trail, 1 mile, Highland Rim and the Millennium Trails are 2 to 2.5 miles, and then the Merritt Ridge is 5.5. And if you connect to the Millennium and the Merritt, you can get a good 8 mile hike out of that.
So the Iron Man hike.
Easy to pretty. That one's
they're
pretty.
They're required
that's
a 5 mile and a 10
hike.
Mile. So that's one of our annual ones. We love the Millennium.
Yeah.
That's a great trail. And this is the time of year too where lots of nuts are coming out. Lots of animals are getting ready.
You're not talking about
lots of crazies.
The nuts came out a couple months ago, but
right. He was just talking about all the crazy.
Nuts are here on the show today.
Acorns are falling, hickory nuts are falling.
Yeah, but this is a great time to see all kinds of wildlife out there.
Oh, thanks,
all the nuts and the wildlife.
And next month, the snake comes back.
I'll bring her back.
Jen didn't get to see her, so I want Jen to see her.
I didn't get,
Jen likes snakes, though.
I do.
Yeah.
Spiders, not so much.
Okay, let's see. Oh, look who's here. Steve Quick and Sandy Brown's here this morning. Now, I know y'all got all kinds of good stuff to tell us about, right?
Yeah, various things. You know, we're...
Yeah, put your mic around there so you get both of you.
Don't be afraid of it, Steve.
Okay.
Yeah. Not a snake.
Now, you're telling them about the Smithville Senior Center dance that you've been involved with.
Right.
And then I got some beef.
Oh, good.
Yeah, the Senior Citizen Dance is every Thursday night up at City Hall and inside Smithville, bringing music back to downtown. And, of course, we've got several good singers and stuff that are in this area, and they look for a place every now and then to try to come and show what they can do, you know. So we invite people to come up, and and it's a $5 charge for most folks that to come in. And of course,
that's a bargain.
Yeah, that's pretty good, pretty little bargain. They seem to enjoy themselves. We get out a decent hour, 10 o'clock, you know. But we have a good time with everybody. And also too, there's a lot of entertainers since the complex opened up. I've been talking to a lot of people that travel around and do music, and Judy Haney is one of them, and also Catherine Adams. They're looking forward to maybe coming up and booking the complex sometime and having people see what they do. So we feel real good about this Thursday night dance. It kind of promotes the music, and then also having the events in the area. Of course, I enjoy doing the radio shows that I do. Voices of the Community radio show, we've been on air, what, now about a little over a year better?
Probably, yes, yeah. About a little over a year. And that's what folks need to be aware of. If they go to that dance, there's a pretty good chance Steve is going to have
I'll
a recorder out
yeah.
there.
Oh, yeah, always
record. He catches me pretty often.
Yeah. But we do have a lot of fun with it, and we'll let Sandy now talk to you more about what she's involved in and doing. And we're
when are the dances?
The dance is on Thursday nights at 7 o'clock.
Every Thursday?
Every Thursday.
Every Thursday, 7 o'clock at City Hall. Yeah.
Great.
And Steve and I, of course, work on Voices of the Community radio show, and we're going to be getting out more and start. We took August off a little bit because we had some other projects going on, and we're going to start. The folks who are members of the chamber are going to start seeing us in their offices, so now's your chance to find an excuse not to be there.
But that's right.
You were talking earlier about Alexandria.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I am tickled to death.
Uh-huh.
Absolutely tickled. Suzanne, I owe you big time, girl, because you were the one who let me know about this opportunity. I have just become, I start officially on September 14th, but I'm going to be the new director of the Alexandria Senior Center.
Woo! Yay! Yes, you'll be awesome. Awesome.
This is
truly, what a win-win.
I know. I am so
congratulations.
Excited.
And yes. That's a great, great bunch of folks there.
I've already been out there. I've been meeting them and talking. You know, I haven't been interviewed for a job in a long time. And that's how I got over my nerves, waiting to go into the room to talk to these mysterious people.
Yeah.
Turned out I knew a bunch of them.
Yeah.
But I got to know the participants out in Alexandria, and this is going to be awesome.
Yes.
But, and tying in again, talking about bringing technology in, you're going to start seeing us on Facebook and a webpage, because the new demographics that's coming in to the senior center, the folks that we're going to start seeing, they're a little more tech savvy than what we've got now, but I'm working on that too. So it's now that they have a new, the building is the same place, but the address has changed. I guess through their 911, the address has been updated to 330 Edgewood.
Okay.
Like I said, it's the same building, but you know.
Yeah.
And you can still get them at 615-529-2928. Or my cell phone, which will be after September 14th, and I can't wait, 931-235-0837, but you can get that off the Voices of the Community website.
Oh, I'm just sure great things will happen in Alexandria.
She will bring the fun down to Alexandria.
That's so great.
Judy Sandlin is my boss.
I know.
Understand, you're my boss too now.
I'm sort of the vice president.
Okay.
Sort of.
I'm in seventh heaven. I got some of the best bosses in the world. I did turn in my resignation with the post office.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Office
mad at me.
I have the luxury of being able to do something I love as opposed to something is just an education.
Yeah. So. Okay. Well, we're excited to have you, and
great.
I think you're going to love it too, Sandy.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
And I know they're going to love you.
Okay.
Well, Steve, thank you for being here too.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. Love hearing all the music and dances going on.
They have the real radio voices over there. I don't know what you and I are doing here. Yeah.
You know, I don't know about Steve, but I'm trying to stay out of the camera shack because this is the face for radio. I'm here to tell you.
Look who's here now from Fast Pacer to Care. I didn't know Taroma was coming this morning. I love Taroma Rigsby. Hello. And Chris Summers is here this morning. Yeah. Good morning. And look at this color, Jen. Oh, don't you
looking good.
Thank you.
Anyway, good morning. Well, update us. Give us updates.
Exciting stuff, Fast Pacer to Care Clinic.
I went over the hours before, things that we're doing, but I'm really excited because now, based on folks needing the service, we're offering primary care one day a week, and we have the lovely Tyrone here that is doing that for us. So I thought it would be good to maybe share the difference between an urgent care visit versus a primary care visit. Uh-huh. So I brought an expert with me today
I don't know about all that.
And so that's what I thought we would do, is just let everybody know, you know, what's the difference when I come in? Urgent care versus primary care.
Yeah. So what's the difference?
Well, first off, I want to thank y'all for having me here. when I've been doing urgent care up there for the past year, and we just saw a need of people coming in for urgent care and not having a primary care provider. A primary care provider is somebody that provides care to you on chronic conditions such as high blood pressure, cholesterol, depression, women's health, stuff such as that, stuff that you take medication for every day. Urgent care is you wake up today, you have a fever, you have the sniffles, you have a cough, cold, you break a toe, you need stitches. There is no appointment necessary for urgent care. Primary care, we schedule you an appointment. The visits usually run with me because I get in there and start talking, usually 20 to 45 minutes. So it's a very detailed, in-depth overview of your overall health care. We're also gatekeepers. So if you need a referral to a specialist, an endocrinologist, pulmonologist, cardiologist, that would be us. Any sort of routine lab work, that would be us. Imaging, MRIs, CT scans, that would be us. So that's kind of the difference. It's more of a scheduled and routine health care, whereas urgent, it's just you wake up with it that day and we can take care of it for you.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you so much.
There you go. Now you know.
She does that so much better.
She does. That was
so pretty, too.
She's so pretty to look at.
Get lulled by the beautiful colors. Oh, thank y'all for being here this morning. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, and thanks for the invitation. I'm looking forward to homecoming parade.
Yeah?
September the 24th.
Oh, I'm glad you told me that day.
We are going to be all tigered out at the clinic.
Oh, yay.
And out front, and also anybody is welcome. If you've not come by and seen the clinic, no sickness required, but come by and see us. I'll give you a tour and for sure on a homecoming for the parade because we're going to be all ready and tigered up for that.
Oh, thank you for giving me the date. I didn't have a date for that.
September the 24th.
Okay. Great.
Awesome. Right.
Thanks,
thank
Chris.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank y'all. Oh, look who's here.
Yay,
Josh Isaac from the Chamber and Community Theater News, I'm sure.
Yes, we are so excited. We have over 60 people in our new cast.
Oh, my gosh.
I know.
It's exciting. They like her cast.
I'm a little stressed. Well, there's a lot of children, and, you know, when it comes to children, you also have their parents.
So it's
a cast of 120. It's been so far, everyone has been so amazing. We just got started, but the show is called When You Wish, and it is a Disney musical. Basically, you're going to see anywhere from Anna and Elsa and Ariel and Buzz and Woody. And then some of my favorite villains would be Ursula and Captain Hook and Cruella. So
Cruella de Vil.
Yeah, we don't have the rights to that song, so don't sing it.
Oh, sorry. Well, you're letting me just a little snippet.
I'm just kidding. But but we do have some sponsors already, but with it being a bigger show, we need more sponsors.
Yeah.
So if you're out there listening and you can help us out, we definitely could use your help. If you think of 60 people, some of them have two or three costume changes. So, you know, it's going to be quite a undertaking, but we do have Project
Hometown.
Sounds
fabulous, though.
Yeah, it is going to be great. But Project Hometown Help is a sponsor. And then also St. Thomas DeKalb has come in there and helped us. And so I'm just going to go over some general things because we're not selling tickets yet, but I've had more people already being like, I want tickets. But I'm trying to get through the first half of the play before I have to start, you know, mini hats, start selling tickets. But it's $10 for general admission, which is a great price, I think.
Yeah.
It's $15 for reserve seating. And what's great is you pay $5 more and you don't have to get there early. Your name's on your seat. You're going to be in the first four rows, you know, so you're not having to fight the crowd. And so that's $15 for those seats. And then we just added two, I'm calling them meet and eat story times.
Oh.
And basically, your child will come and they will get to meet meet, and we'll have snacks and stuff, and they'll get to meet all the characters, get their autographs.
Have their picture made with them?
Yeah, have their picture made, and guess what? We're going to do a special little segment for them, our own routine, little thing that we're going to do for them, and have a story time also. So it's going to be a great little thing. That's an extra $10 per child, but then the parents are free.
Cheaper than going to Disney.
Let me tell you. Just got back from that. I can guarantee you that's a deal.
Yeah, it's a deal. And but now the I just want to say the reserve seating and the meet and eat is only there's only so many tickets. So once they're sold, you know, I'm not going to fit you in.
Right. Yeah. I mean, like some people think Josh can. He can do miracles with his last minute tickets.
If you call him at least three times, he will.
Yeah.
Just so you know.
And we're looking to sell out, and the thing is that we're only allowed to have so many people in the building.
Yeah.
So really think of that, because in the past, you know, we've tried to fit because we had tables. This time it's going to be straight seating.
Yeah.
And but it's November 7th and 8th, so mark your calendar and watch my Facebook. You can look me up on Facebook at Josh Isaac, and when the tickets come available, you'll see it on there.
You're doing such a great thing of promoting the princesses and some of the main roles on Facebook. I have to look every time.
I know. So I put at least one a day.
And it's so fun. And then it's kind of neat too, because I've known some of these kids their whole lives, but I haven't seen them as a teenager or, you know, in the role that they are.
They
and
look
I think,
like
oh,
the characters.
They're all grown up. Yeah. I know. It's really great.
And last night we mixed the music. And if you'll watch my Facebook today, I added a new character. It's the fairy godmother. Uh-huh. I'm not going to tell you who it is. So watch on Facebook today to see who the fairy godmother is going to be.
Okay. How exciting. So great.
If not, well, let me say, when it gets close to time for this thing to happen, the November, he is going to be a pill to handle at the chamber.
Oh, no, he can juggle it all.
No, he gets grouchy.
No.
Stressed. Yeah, yeah. He's like me before annual banquet.
Yeah, but it does take lots of folks. And so if you're interested in sponsoring helping, if you have access to some of the different specialty kind of costumes, I know you're having to rent some of the costumes.
If you build her, you know, we need builders to help with the set.
So if this builders. is of interest to you, if you have experience or don't have experience, it takes a lot of folks to put this together. So that's what you're doing right now.
Well, we appreciate all you do, honestly.
Thanks, Josh.
All joking aside. Oh, Jen.
Yes.
Let's see. What are you handing out applications for now? I've been seeing that.
Oh,
happen.
Yeah. It's that time of year.
What time of year?
Leadership DeKalb, my favorite time. We are starting our new class at the end of September. So this is the time that we are really looking for folks, anyone who lives or works in DeKalb County and is interested in making a positive impact on the future of DeKalb County. Josh just went through the program,
I know,
class president.
Yeah.
Josh, what would you say if someone thought whether they would be interested in Leadership DeKalb or not?
You know, it's crazy because I was actually thinking about this. And what's funny is that I was thrown into it last year because I just started the chamber.
We said, you have to know what this program is.
I loved it. One of the best things is that you really learn what all your county has to offer. And I would challenge anyone who says, I know whatever my county has to offer. They don't. They have no idea I thought I knew everything.
I learn something every year. And this is
so I'm interested. And you meet people that's going to be family. We meet at least once a month and they have lunch or do something. Or just meet each other just to chat and see what's going on. So it becomes your family.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yes, he has. Oh, let me tell you. They stopped by the chamber. This guy, he's like a friend magnet. He's awesome.
Yeah.
But a lot of those friends he gained through.
But I think anyone who, when your class was the same way.
I think
there are three benefits to going through the leadership program. Number one, it is leadership development. So we are looking for emerging leaders, folks who are looking to get more involved, or folks like Jacob Young, a new leader in the community.
Mm-hmm.
It is leadership development. So we do try and stress different critical skills that can benefit everyone in being a more effective leader. Number two, you create a family, a network mm-hmm. within your own class. So the learning happens within the class and not just the third aspect of it, which is meeting with current leaders in DeKalb County. So we'll meet with county and city officials, business leaders, the healthcare. We have so many wonderful gems that little things, big things that you may not know are going on in DeKalb County that we get to meet those folks, go to their place like New Frontiers, see the exciting things that are happening throughout the county.
So, and we get to have state government trip.
Yeah, and then we go to state government and we learn what it means to be an advocate for our own interests and opinions. So
and you eat.
And you eat. The food's pretty good.
Yeah.
So if anyone who is interested or if you know someone who might be, please have them contact me, 615-464-0645, or they can call the chamber office at 615-597-4163, and we'll be sure and get them all the information they need.
Yeah, and it's a limited number of people you can take, so
yeah,
get it in there today.
Yeah, actually, this Friday is the application deadline, although the first session is not until September 24th, so we'll...
We're so excited.
I love it.
Well, I tell you, this is going to be a busy month coming up. But anyway, the Chamber wants to help promote your news or special events, so give us a call at 615-597-4163 or email us at DeKalbTN@DTCcom.net. We'll help you spread the word.
That's right. Watch those colors change outdoors.
Yeah, well, I'm so thankful for my co-host, Leadership DeKalb Director, Jen Sherwood. And I think we've had a whole big crowd of lots of co-hosts this morning.
This was great.
I tell you, but we had great special guests, but we want to thank DTC TV and WJL Radio for sponsoring our Chamber Chat, and hope you have a wonderful September, everyone.